Hello everyone, I am Tyler Morrison of Link Technologies. I'm a network engineer and consultant, and I'll be presenting to you today about the PowerLINK and 6 commonly asked questions. Stay tuned for the end of the video how you can win an 8-watt PowerLINK. The PowerLINK is a passive PoE bridge with a built-in access point available in 8-watt and 15-watt models. Every installer and technician should carry one in their toolbox. When you receive your PowerLINK, you'll receive the unit, RJ45 patch cable, USB flashlight, and USB charge cable, quick start guide, all contained in a carrying case. The radio card is AL211BGN on frequency 2462. It is an open access point. The SSID is www.linktex.net. There is a management interface you can access to make configuration changes. All models you can access over SSH or WinSCP. In firmware version 4, you can access over the web GUI interface. Management interface is accessible via 192.168.1.69 and a /24 subnet mask. You must be within the same subnet mask to access the management interface. The login for the portal is root username with a password Jiva. The PowerLINK has open wart operating system to allow you to do IPERF testing. You may also change your mode to bridge mode, router mode, a DHCP client, DHCP server, or anything else that may suit your needs. Operating the PowerLINK is very simple and easy to use. First, you may want to start by checking the battery level. Make sure its battery is full. It's good to have a full battery for 24 volt and especially for the 8 volt power conversions. You may notice whenever I hit the test button, my USB temporarily activates. To use it fully, constant stream USB, slide the OCR switch to C. To use router functions or even access point or PoE functions, slide the toggle switch all the way to R for router mode. On the RJ45 port, there is a toggle switch. Away from the dot, PoE is off. When the toggle switch is on the dot, PoE is active. So the first question we get a lot is, I plugged my device into my PowerLINK and it's not powering on. What's wrong? First thing you want to do is check the battery level, make sure your PowerLINK is full, especially for when you're using 24 volt and 48 volt conversions. Next, you want to slide your OCR switch to R, router mode, let it run. Then check your PoE toggle switch and make sure PoE is on. Slide it towards the dot. In my demonstration, I'm going to use a MicroStick map. It has 24 volt and 48 volt input options. Then connect it. We're getting power. Optionally, what we offer to you is a 24 volt to 48 volt converter. As two sides, input and output. Input goes into your PowerLINK, output goes to your 48 volt device. On longer cable runs, recommend using the RJ45 coupler to extend your cable run. And real quick, we'll demonstrate 48 volt conversion. Input. And as you can tell, we are getting 48 volt. Our second question has been about a PowerLINK feature with the failsafe. The failsafe, you may notice, your PowerLINK is turned on, you plug in the device, and immediately your PowerLINK may shut off. This is normal. This may be due to either invalid pin layout or some kind of short circuit. To fix this, you want to power down your PowerLINK, grab your charge cable, and charge your PowerLINK for a few seconds or more, and turn your PowerLINK back on. Our third question is Cambium compatible with PowerLINK? Yes, it is. You may also want to consult with your manual to see what your Cambium product requires. Some products require a 24 volt to 48 volt converter, such as this, or you may need a rollover crossover cable reverse polarity. EPMP series has reverse polarity built into the mix. Others do not. Our fourth question about the PowerLINK is, can the Wi-Fi settings be changed? Yes, they can. You'll want to access the management interface, and from there, you can access your wireless card, you can change the SSID, add or remove a passkey, and change your frequency. By default, the frequency is 2462, and 2.4 GHz is only 3 non-overlapping channels, 2412, 2437, and 2462. If you're on a job site with a client radio on 2462 and your PowerLINK is on 2462, you will have self-interference. To solve this, you'll want to set your power link to either 2412, 2437, or auto frequency. Our fifth question is, I have my Wi-Fi turned on, my power link. My device connects to my power link, but my device gives up trying to connect, basically from DHCP timeout or lack of IP. By default, the power link is a bridge access point. There is no IP authority. It is assumed that your device on the other side of the power link will hand out your IP addressing, or you need to set a stack IP address on your computer. Our sixth question is, I made configuration changes and I would like to reset it back to default. Two ways of doing this. Easiest way, you can set access management interface, is to go through there, do a system reset. If you cannot access your management interface or it's become unresponsive, you want to power off your power link. On the battery test side, lower corner is a small pinhole. Apply pressure to the reset button and power on your power link. And now what you've been waiting for, the details for the contest. Like this video, subscribe to this channel before
December 25th, 2019.
Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more tips and tricks. My hop count is over. Time to look at season.